very devastating bubbles and paddle stars. Definitely going to make it difficult on the side of PGG, and they are going to put the Lucian bottom with the Braum. So definitely can make those early plays and value out of your ultimate as well. Good move here from Showmaker after pushing up to be able to keep track of Pabu. And if Udyr just continues to power clear, here we go, teleport behind them though.
Some damage TP and Ignite there on the Braum. Not the ideal target. Flashes in for the Q, but they're still splitting damage back and forth. And Praetith finds first blood. The re-engage is still going to mean a kill. And how about the chase down though? Next time this is
PGG. Yep. And the top side jungle presence actually amounts to nothing there for Damwon. Yeah, they lose out on their Krugs and a large window where Biopanther actually won't be able to join, and he's not going to be able to join for two reasons.
And the Morgul, but the Bind's going to miss. A crucial bit of damage not going to land. Threw it the wrong way. He didn't get pushed as far as he thought he was. So at least survival for Biopanther. Now a re-engage to the mid side is Showmaker at 400 HP. So Chaz doing some decent damage there, but the gold lead shrinking away from him, or the CS lead, as Rift Herald some of the top side. This one near enough to the turret that's going to get some damage. It's going to be the entire turret taken down. Kanyan going to go ahead and share that gold together. 660 across the two, and now second dragon gets picked up. I like the try. Ghost try several times for the
bladed solo laner here. You see already completing the Gore Drinker. First mythic done as well. We do have the exhaust getting pulled out.
Oh, the flash in for the auto attack, but that means a flash and an ulti is easy. Barrel, that is one of the worst plays I have seen, but it might still set it for the rest of it. The shield's not back up. The auto comes in for Ghost. I take it all back. It was the long con.
Early flashes resulting in his death, but at least he finds his hook.
Lands this one. Paddle stars a ton of damage. The shield is on. The ignite seals the deal, though.
This is the weak side of the map. They've got the full top side lit up.
Yeah.
A little bit more care, though.
Flash stun, Gale Force. I love it.
There, man. They get the bounty off of Ghost there. Is going to cost them as well across the map.
Okay, looking out of play now in the mid lane as TP's come through as well. They're going to find a bit of damage. Canyon's black shield times out, so he has to flash away from what might have been some decent CC. Battlefront takes a chunk, not going to matter. Top lane being pushed in, so I'm going to answer that soon as Khan is shoving in past the rubble of the first turret and he's about to crash into tier two. So Chaz maybe walks there? No, it's going to be free turret damage, actually. As Biopanther finishes his recall to walk up, that sleep could mean a lot. Shield comes in, not at all. Ooh. Decoy just takes a million damage. Why did he not put the shield up? It might have been on cooldown, but...
For Damwon, it has to be PGG looking for the kills.
Smite for a slow, easy stun. I notice that he doesn't walk to the left because he doesn't want to give a good ult target, but it's not going to matter. Of course, Ghost still presses R, but I saw him. I saw him kind of check that instinct. Like, wait a second. The farther left I walk, the farther away from Chaz he goes. Still going to be a trade of health bars in the brush. They're going to find a stun, decent damage, and a barrel anchor tosses backwards. Now, what about the re-engage from Canyon? Who will he bind? What they're going to get with a sleepy trouble bubble, maybe? Nice culling is decent damage as Chaz is there for the reinforcements. Puts the gravity well down.
I don't think they were ever super worried about losing control of the mid-game dragons there. So that's why they kind of didn't pay much attention to the early ones.
Really start to worry for your life. Every Showmaker bubble could result in the follow-up pick there from Damwon. And that's going to be the next couple of minutes.
The second time. Let's see about the pick, though.
Oh, yep. Ward hops in, gets the stop, and now in the 2v1, it might just be easy. Sidesteps the Sonic Wave, but not a problem for Soul Shackles. Khan claims the kill. Dragon spawns in 145. Could be pretty usefully on the ANZ side. As the combo comes in, huge damage. He's burning down. Praetith will drop. Good setup and knockdown by a barrel. Bit of help from Canyon, sure, but support difference there 100% of the time.
Yep, he finds the pick. You get credit for the ultimate and the hook. Canyon there for the follow-up binding. You don't get to move against this team. Showmaker also with the Glacial.
Big damage. Oh, he can't get it. Nice stun. Pabu sitting there in bear stance. Stuns before Khan could go for the ward hop. This is why sometimes you have to flash for the kick, because you can channel the kick, then flash into range if you ward hop first. Outside of really
not
tricky...
Not going to be the case here, though, because Damwon early setup here on this dragon. 20 seconds ahead. Khan goes for
it. There we go. We got the ward hop to kick backwards. Give him an eternal. That is a bicycle kick, according to the League of Legends official game. Client Showmaker. Oh, my. Burns his flash, knocks him down. Of course, beautifully played setup there by Khan. Give big respect to Insect, the man that actually popularized the play. And now the engage continues. Lock of Shield comes in into the back line, goes Ghost, and he is going to knock one down already. Into the graveyard goes Pabu. Now time for a bit more as, hey, they got Barrel back, but it's still a 3v4 on the map, and it's time for the rest of PGG to turn tail and run, and Decoy is going to be sacrificed on the way out.
As well, Damwon continue to fire. I like how Showmaker
doesn't give up on the con play.
Look, much worse, honestly. They're gonna try yet again now. Okay, easy jump back for Khan. He's going to be safe. Bit of damage towards Vero. Puts the ulti in. A root there. They are going to find a single kill. Culling's going to push back a bit more damage. For now, Ghost ready for the re-engage and shuts down two. Nicely done. Snipe's going to land on a Biopanther.
Try and dodge his way in there. Maybe go for the Hail Mary Baron.
Nope, he's recalling.
All right, well, that's going to be the siege coming from Dom 1 then.
Wait, I've seen this before. You can't just recall in the exact same spot. Come on, Pablo, you had infinite time to run somewhere else. Well, the man's going to run for his life. There's no way he actually lives. He's going to dodge the Everfrost root. All right, the boy is dead. Thumbs up for Teemo. I realize that, like,
okay,
getting...
I'll let it fly.
Yeah, because I don't think it's three in hips. I don't think it's ever three in hips here, right? So I would never take that side of it. So I'm going to, you know, I would say equal. Over, under, equal would be my call. So here we go. Looking at turret number one in front of the base. Easy pickup there. Still a minute and a half on this Baron buff. And now they're going to knock down the inhibitor. And hey, by the way, they're going for the Nexus itself. The turrets are up. And if Nexus is just one big inhibitor that keeps your whole base from dying, then that might be number two. Looking now at the defense is Pentanet. As mid lane, not going to be too terribly pushed in. In fact, it's actually hitting Dom 1's middle outer. So it's just kind of pushing for the game. They're not going for anything bigger than this. They're not going for second lane. They're just going for the game ender. Still a minute and 8 seconds as the cannon keeps shooting in. The next wave reinforced with Baron Buffon. They're not easily killed. Big stun to the front line already to delete one. And a double stun from Nautilus is huge as they're going to find the dive in. A nice jump backwards keeps Praedith safe. It looks to kill Canyon. Chaz already dropped down though. It's a 2-for-0. Jumping in as Canyon gets the ulti, looking to get the setup as the rest of the squad comes in. And the Canyon duo finds himself their second kill. Beautifully done for the squad. And goodbye. There is the ace. And I was right. And so was Dom 1. They are going to be slaughtering this game. A 27-minute victory. They're going to knock down the second Nexus turret. They're going to knock down the Nexus itself. And right through the bottom lane, 17-5. Dom 1 Kia claim the top seed out of the Rumble stage.
Confident play there. Their last